Sharp presents from parts unknown, the Crusher. And to my left, weighing in at 300 pounds from the Zulu Nation in Africa, the mighty Zulu.
Zulu, this is your last chance. I've tried to talk to you all week. I sent you telegrams, you ignored them. I called you on the phone, you hung up on them. Let me tell you something. You do have a little bit of talent. If you let me take that talent and develop it, you can avoid getting whippings from men like this. I'm not going to tell you one more time. I finally got a chance to talk to you face to face, and I want an answer. Are you going to come with me? Are you going to have to take a beating before you finally learn something in this business? You'll be sorry. You'll be sorry.
Well, what an unexpected surprise here.
Rick Hester, your referee for this bout.
Crusher, show no mercy for as long as you feel like it.
The pretty boy Larry Sharp claiming that he's been trying to contact the Zulu all week to try to get together. I don't know what to make of that. He's now told the Crusher to unload on him. I'll talk about that world title bout when we get a chance. We're going to watch the pretty boy Larry Sharp and the Crusher. Oh, this Crusher is the big man. We saw him crush that can, actually bite into it in the interview last week. Zulu is the opponent tonight, and as this bout is underway, the Crusher locks up the Zulu, a big man himself from Africa, the Zulu Nation there, where he picked up his name. The Crusher picks him up and throws him through the air across the ring. Golly. This Crusher, like I say, appears to be a fiendish sort of individual. If you can withstand that type of heated tattoo on your head, you've got to be able to be pretty tough. Muscles flexing on the Zulu as he has the Crusher locked up. Crusher picks him up. And Crusher Yurka remains in the headlock by the Zulu as Larry Sharp shouts encouragement from ringside. Understand this Crusher is unusual for his size in that he's very fast in the ring for a big man. Can move in the ring with great speed. Zulu back into a shoulder butt and he goes down. Look how quickly the Crusher moves over on him, bends him over the rope. I don't know if you can hear Larry Sharp or not. He's saying something like, save yourself a beating and listen to me. Zulu is thrown out of the corner and rolling over. Kerry and Kevin's corner for the world title. We hope to have Kerry with us here next week. Down goes the Zulu on that great card here in Fort Worth. Drop kick again. That's two we've seen from the Crusher. And Larry Sharp is all over the Zulu verbally. I'm trying to be quiet so we can pick up on that. I think he said something about an opportunity of a lifetime. Crusher still punishing the Zulu in the corner. It's been all Crusher here in this bout. And keep in mind, Zulu is the guy who's coming here and giving Abdullah what for. There's Larry Sharp moving around. One, two, and looked like the Crusher may have pulled him up. Kerry in the Kevin's corner for the world title. We hope to have him here Monday, a part of that great card at Will Rogers Coliseum. We take a week off Friday night. That's October the 10th as we prepare for the Cotton Bowl Extravaganza the 12th. So be with us Monday at Will Rogers Coliseum. We'll have choice seats available for the Cotton Bowl for our in-person fans. Abdullah the Butcher versus Bruiser Brody. Still don't have a referee. Over and down goes the Zulu. As the search continues, we might look at the Crusher come down. We might have to have a bout without a referee, if you can imagine. Because the bout's going to go on.
I can make you a champion, boy. I can make you a champion.
Listen to Larry Sharp, the pretty boy. Hollering at the Zulu, who's being punished severely by the Crusher. Elbow. Larry Sharp moving around, staying around the Zulu wherever he can be. Pressure has him over the top rope, choking. Harry Sharp still on the Zulu. Here's another pin. One, two, and again, the Crusher comes up. Black Bart coming up. We'll be talking to the Von Erich, Steve Simpson, Bruiser Brody, as Zulu is out on the floor. Now Larry Sharp has got the Zulu around the neck. He's not trying to hurt him. Larry Sharp talking to the Zulu. Again, he's been on him for the entire bout. Now Zulu moving back into the ring where the Crusher waits patiently. Zulu now moves in with a headbutt. And Zulu again backs the Crusher off, and down he goes. For the first time in this bout, the Zulu has momentum on the big man, the Fiend, the Crusher Yurko. With a corner, the Crusher is thrown, and the Zulu all of a sudden has come from nowhere and has gotten the thing going in this bout. Down goes the Crusher. Crowd beginning to get wound up now in this bout. Count of two, Crusher kicks him off. Give credit to the Zulu, he has come on. Now the Crusher picks him up. And down goes the Zulu. Crusher back on top. Count of two, and that's all. Larry Sharp still hollering at the Zulu. Here's a headbutt by the Crusher. In the corner goes the Crusher. Zulu coming back now on his own. Several times in this bout, the Crusher, I think, could have pinned Zulu 1-2-3, but has elected not to. Count of two by referee Rick Hazard. Larry Sharp moving round and round the ring. He stays in a position where the Zulu can hear him. It sounds to me like the pretty boy is trying to get to the Zulu. Look at that big splash falling down. Actually, the head more than a splash. Zulu down, the Crusher lays him down. And comes down with the back of the knee. Now the Crusher steps out of the ring. Zulu laying flat there. Zulu breathing all right, but the last few drives by the Crusher laid him flat. Here comes the Crusher diving from the top rope. One, two, three. Crusher hit him so hard he grimaced himself. And the Crusher Yurkov has won this bout.
In 11 minutes, 15 seconds, the winner of the match, the Crusher.
Larry Sharp hollering at the Zulu. I can only guess that perhaps Sharp told Zulu something during that bout when the Zulu turned it on in an effort to try to get to him, because other than that, it was all Crusher in that bout. Now, we might have problems here as Larry Sharp is in the face of the Zulu, but also Sharp told the Crusher, don't do any more. I keep seeing Sharp say opportunity. Larry Sharp, a new manager that we've not seen in the world class, appears to be in a strong lobbying effort with the Zulu. Well, this is evidently going to continue a while. I don't want to leave. I don't know if Zulu's going to open up on him or what. The Zulu seems to be following him out and talking to him.
Come with me, we'll talk. Come with me, we'll talk. Come on, we'll talk right now.
And Zulu, I guess, is going to follow Larry Sharp up the aisle.
And now we bring you a strange Tulu.
What have you done to him?
And look at how he holds his chest up high now. Look how he sticks it out. Look at that head. You're looking at the new Zulu Gaddafi, the man that I've already hooked up to fight Ricky the Dragon Steve-O in the Cotton Bowl, because I promised this man top matches and that he was going